Welcome to Kit Catastrophe. My name is Kit, and today we'll be taking a look at Transformers Studio Series Deluxe Class Sideswipe. This figure came out in 2018 as part of Wave 5 of the Deluxe Assortment, and represents Sideswipe's appearance in the 2011 film Transformers Dark of the Moon. Just as in the third Transformers movie, Sideswipe transforms into a concept Corvette Stingray convertible, coated in a sea of shimmering silver paint, accentuating the sensual and seductive curves and lines of this sexy sports car. I'm honestly surprised the paint budget allowed such a splurge on all this paintwork, as pretty much every single square inch of this car is coated. The only exception would be the rims, as they're cast in comparatively dull, light bluish-gray plastic. The paint isn't only relegated to the silver color, however, as the taillights, front grille, and air intakes are picked out in red and black, respectively. Up at the nose, further applications of red and black paint pick out the minuscule Corvette logo, which shows a nice attention to detail. Since Sideswipe is a convertible, there exists a sculpted quote-unquote interior with seats, a steering wheel, and a center console. Obviously, the robot thighs get in the way of there being any sort of legroom, but it's still very cool to see. One problem you may have with this vehicle mode is that there is a dearth of clearance underneath the car, meaning it's a tough time getting this thing to roll. Honestly though, how many of us are going to roll it around on our desks? Okay, put your hands down. Let's transform this thing. Somewhat like Drift in my last review, Sideswipe's transformation utilizes some parts forming, which is punishable by stoning in some parts of the world. The lower sides of the doors come off as accessories at the very start, and you can remove the exhaust pipes soon after. The actual transformation scheme itself is very reminiscent of the Dark of the Moon Deluxe figure, which I guess is appropriate. The main difference, of course, being that the robot mode is formed the correct way around, with the rear becoming the chest and the front becoming the feet. The kibble is also better managed, actually folding around on itself and locking together quite solidly to form a backpack, even if moving the pieces around is a chore. Bayver's Sideswipe is one of my favorite Transformers designs, and it's easily my favorite Sideswipe design. He's sleek, slender, and drives a fine line between being athletic and being buff. He features a digitigrade rotodactylic design that was a plum in many a Revenge of the Fallen era design, yet appears the most refined on Sideswipe. The taillights and their respective fenders provide a very nice set of shoulder pads. Surprisingly, given the glimmering alternate mode, Sideswipe features some paint applications only seen in robot mode. He features some gunmetal paint at his midriff and another painted Corvette logo at his solar plexus. Finally, he has some more gunmetal on his cat-like face, as well as all-spark blue picking out his eyes. Strangely enough, the back of his head is cast entirely in clear plastic for an abandoned light piping gimmick. On his back hang what remain of his doors, which are adjustable on their ball joint connections. For storage reasons, I usually keep them hanging straight down, but if you're in the mood for dynamic speed skater poses, you can easily sweep them backwards and outwards for dramatic effect. Sideswipe comes with two pairs of accessories, the first being his iconic arm-mounted blades, which peg into the slots on the backs of his hands. They're a lot sharper and far more substantial than the ones that adorned both the Revenge of the Fallen and Dark of the Moon deluxes, though it doesn't quite capture the growing out of the arm effect as well. Still, it's a valiant attempt, and one I'm not unhappy with. Complementing Sideswipe's melee prowess are something a little more long-range, his dual pistols. They're wonderfully sculpted, and even feature some black and silver paint in the main body of the weapon. If you prefer not to have Sideswipe wield these in his hands, you can store them in some slots on what was once the car's dashboard, which kind of gives Sideswipe a booster rocket effect. Now we know he can side swipe, but can he side glance? And the answer is yes. He has a ball jointed head that allows him to look 360 degrees all the way around, and it can look up very appreciably, which is pretty nice, and it can look down very appreciably, so he can look sad or dejected or joyful. Like I said before, the wings, the door wings here are on a ball jointed joint. Like I said before, the doors here are on a ball joint that allows them to go in various different ways, and they have a little hinge joint that allows them to hinge upwards or downwards to whatever effect you prefer. Similarly,
the shoulder pad booby lights can ball joint out that far, and they're connected to a hinge. It allows them to extend or retract, and they can go up or down, and they can emote. So if you want that sort of thing, Bob is your uncle. At the shoulder, he has a ball joint that allows him a very good range, despite the very large size of his mammaries. And he can go all the way out, so he can... At the bicep, he has a swivel that goes all the way around, and, as you can see, he has a little shruggy joint due to transformation, but that's irrelevant. He has a bicep swivel here, and a very good elbow that goes just about 90 degrees, which is good in my book. One thing I actually didn't find out until today was that he has a waist swivel. It goes about that far in that direction, and it only goes about that far in that direction because his hip bangs into the steering wheel back here. So that's unfortunate, but it does mean he can get some rather natural-looking curves going on inside of his body. At the hips, he has another ball joint that goes forward. It can't go that far backward because of all the kibble in the way of his butt, but he can high kick you in the face. At the thigh, he has another swivel that goes all the way around, and it's actually very tight, so that's good for stability. Now, at the knees, I always have a little trouble talking about digitigrade knees because one is technically a knee and this is technically an ankle, but he also has other stuff down here which can also count as an ankle. So I'll just call these two knees. He has a first knee that goes all the way back there, and as you can see, he has a little hydraulic joint there that for that 2009 Mecha Live action, which is something I'm really happy to see. I always liked Mecha Live, it was pretty nifty. And he has a second joint here that can go all the way back, so if you pair these up, he can kick his own butt, which is also very good. And this is about as far forward as they can go. And at the foot, the toe can point, and the heel can come forward like that, so you can easily adjust his stability in any pose you'd like, but obviously he doesn't have very many problems standing. As you can see, he's very stable, even if I move his center of balance in some ways, like move it forward, move it backward, he still doesn't fall over. So, yeah, damn, he's good.
Sideswipe is a stellar figure from the Studio Series lineup and is easily the best in his wave by far. Both of his modes look amazing and screen accurate, and his transformation is dynamic and fun. His accessories make for a fun play pattern and diversify display options. I do have a soft spot for the Sideswipe from Bayformers, it's no secret. This figure, I feel, really does him justice. If you liked this video, please share and subscribe. This has been Kit Catastrophe. Transform and roll out.